Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video, we are going to test and see this NJK5002C HAL magnetic sensor. Closer will turn on. We're going to turn on and off an AC bulb using magnetic field detection. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link in the description, which is below the video. And which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Let's get started with this. This is the HAL sensor, and the model number is NJK5002C. Finally, we are getting something from eBay and AliExpress that has a model number. And internally, this has a HAL sensor. The job of HAL sensor is to detect magnetic field. When magnetic field or a magnet is close to this, it detects it and will send low signal. This also has a light here when it detects it. This can operate between 5 to 36 volts. It draws around 10 milliampere, very low current. Any magnet or magnetic field that approaches at this point, this will detect it. So it can have multiple application in robotics and production line and automation, that it detects position of other object that has magnet. So what you do is you will either put magnetic actual magnet on the other piece or electromagnet that attached to the arm or to the element that is getting close to this one, or maybe the other piece is stationary and this is attached to something that moves. So you will have a magnet at certain position, and when it approaches, gets closer, this will turn on. And it has, the length of this wire is 112 centimeter or 44 inches. The module weighs 40 grams. The diameter is 11.7 millimeter. This nut is 16.5 millimeter. The length of this sensor up to this point is 31.8 millimeter. Also, this LED will turn on when it detects a magnetic field close to it. I've got these pen headers, which I'm going to attach to these wires. This will be connected to 5 volts. This will be connected to the ground. This is the output from this. With the load trigger, I'm gonna explain it in the code and on the diagram. And here, this has just nut, and also briefly explaining you the relay. The relay has 3 pins here. These 2 pins are normally open, and this one is normally closed. Whatever wiring you do, you always will have your one wire at the middle, and the other will be either here, which will be normally closed, and here, which will be normally open. What it means is, when the signal comes to the relay, these 2 wires will connect. This side, we have VCC, which will be connected to 5 volts, ground will be connected to the ground, and N will be connected to the input of your Arduino, which is pin 8. This green light will turn on when it receives signal and the relay is energized. This LED will turn on when you connect the relay to 5 volts. When you're using a relay, pay attention to the current rating of a relay. For example, this is a very tiny relay, and the current rating is 2 ampere for 30 volts, 0.5 ampere for 100 volts, and 0.6 ampere for 125 volts. This is the amount of current that it can handle. And this can handle 10 ampere at 28 volts and 10 ampere at all voltages, 120 and 250 and 30 volts. So to understand how much this can handle, in North America, the voltage is 120 volts times 10 ampere is 1,200 watt or 1.2 kilowatt. If you're in Asia and Europe, the voltage is, let's say, 220 or 240 volts. For 220 times 10 is 2,200 watt or 2.2 kilowatt this relay can handle. And the same way, this one, you have to also multiply the voltage times the current to get the power. And the same way, this is a 12 volt relay, but the rating is 10 ampere for majority of the voltages. To avoid fire and overheating, do not allow the current above the rated current to pass through this relay. And here is the setup and diagram that I've done. The positive 5 volts, this is 5 volts connected to the VCC and to the Hall sensor, and this ground or negative is also connected to the ground of this relay and to this sensor, and this black wire is connected to the in of this relay, and my load is also connected to the bulb. So this is my bulb now, and this is connected to the AC load, and the magnet will be proximity of this sensor. This is an AC desktop bulb, and this is a power plug that I connected to the wall, and 120 volts, which will turn on and off. Now, at this point, I've cut one of these two wires at this point and twisted it and soldered it, can be connected to relay. Job of relay is to connect this, and the AC bulb is on, or AC load, whatever fan you have, and disconnect it to turn it off. So I will be connecting these two to the relay. My AC bulb, now AC load is connected to this relay, I'm not touching it. And this is a sensor. And if I put the north pole of the magnet, it will not be triggered. So the position of the sensor inside is such that it will be triggered only with the south pole. And here is the slide, and also you will see it there. So it's you can have electromagnet or whatever way of magnet, but the polarity is very important, because this will not work. It will not work from even this distance, so you have to be very close. And it will not work from the side, because the metal is blocking the path of electromagnetic field. From the sensor, we have the three wires. The brown is connected to 5 volts, blue is connected to the ground, and the black is connected to pin 2. For the relay, VCC. For the relay, this VCC is connected to 5 volts, the middle one is connected to the ground, and then the last one, which is the N, the orange one, connected to pin 8. The two wires of the AC bulb that I shown you are connected to these two pins of this relay. Let me now explain the code. We first define the sensor pin, pin 2. There is no semicolon or anything, so you can use any digital pin that you want to use. Make sure it's available. And this is a relay pin, pin 8. We will use this pin to connect to the relay. And this weight variable of type integer is 3000 milliseconds or 3 seconds. This is the amount of time that when the switch turns on the relay, you want to wait this amount of time. If you want this one to be real time, just make it zero. As soon as the switch is off, the relay will be off. It's up to you. Inside the setup, which starts from here to here, this code will run only once. We use pin mode. We say pin mode sensor pin, which we have defined here, pin 2. This is as if we type 2 here, and we say input pull-up, because this sensor needs a pull-up resistor. I've explained it in a separate video in this link. You can watch it. So it just eliminates usage of extra resistor. And then we go pin mode. This time we relay define the relay pin as an output. This was as an input. This is an output. And we initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud, so we can print this text for us here. And this must match the 9600 baud on this side, must match this number in order to be able to read it. Inside the loop, which starts from here to here, this will run continuously. We do the digital read, sense pin, we are reading pin 2, and the result of this, either if it's sensed or not, will be stored in the sensed integer, because the sense is either 0 or 1. So we are storing it in an integer. So 0 or 1 in Arduino means low or high. Then we say if sensed equal low. This equal is used for comparison. One equal is for assignment. You assign value, but here we compare. We say if sense is equal or if it's low, then we print this on the screen here. It will show it like this. And then digital write relay pin low. This goes to pin 8 and sets it to low. Because my relay is low trigger, I put low. If your relay is different, put high. So turn on mean, put it to low, and also wait for the amount of time that you set above. And if there is no wait or the wait is zero, it just go immediately after that. And if it's not low, the sense is not low, then you go to the else and we say digital write relay pin high. This now turns off the relay again as the above. If you're reversing this, if this is high, this must be low. If this is low, this must be high. So change it accordingly. In my case, it's just high, and then I just print this one to print this dash. I didn't say sense or anything to show that there is something. It did not detect anything. 300 milliseconds is the wait to avoid hysteresis or continuous connection and disconnection. So you can play with this, but my experiment 300 milliseconds was good. Let me now demonstrate. This is a serial monitor. The relay is connected. This is my AC bulb here. And the proximity sensor is here. Now if I put this closer, will turn on. And also you can see it's just sensed. It needs to be very aligned. A little distance will not work. Even like this, it will not work. So the pole must be on this side. And also, as you can see, the light, the LED will turn on here. If I put the other pole, the north pole, will not work. The magnetic field now goes like this. It must be within this area. If I'm holding it, it just continuously shows sensed. The amount of time that is running at the moment was zero. So if I make this 3 seconds, now this is set at 3 seconds. If I remove it, within 3 seconds it's on still. If I set this 0, and if you won't respond, but this one, which is 300 milliseconds, if I make this 0, now pay attention with this 0, the delay, the main delay. So you will not get the result because it will be too quick, connect and disconnect. I would suggest play with this to find an optimal time. My experience was 300, but maybe millisecond, 300 millisecond, and maybe in your application you need 100 millisecond or less or more. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this NJK5002C HAL sensor. If you like and learn something from this video, please thumb up. If you have question or comment, please post it in the comment section. I'll try to answer and reply. And please don't forget to subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming cool videos.